En we schenken aandacht aan Elvis Presley, de koning van de rock, die dinsdag stierf en vanavond wordt begraven.
Elvis Presley, late of Tupelo, Mississippi, Memphis, Tennessee, Las Vegas and Beverly Hills, died today. He was only 42 years old, but while he lived, he revolutionized the music business. And in one way or another, he touched most our lives. He was a truck driver in the early 50s who thought he could sing. And when he did at county fairs or at rinky-dink theaters in small southern towns, he made the crowds go crazy. The smart guys in the music business spotted him, signed him, and made the name Elvis part of the American folk history. Well, Elvis died today in the town he loved most. In Memphis, several men close to Presley in the last days held a news conference after a hospital spokesman described what happened to the 42-year-old singer.
Some of his employees, they immediately began emergency resuscitation procedures, and the Memphis Fire Department ambulance continued these cardiopulmonary resuscitation procedures all the way into the emergency department. There will be a postmortem examination done. The physician feels that the indication is that it's a possible heart attack, but we won't know until that examination has been completed.
Well, he was upstairs in his bedroom, and I went upstairs to talk to him, and he wasn't breathing when I got up there.
Was he lying on the bed?
Yeah.
Has he been despondent over anything or anything?
I have no idea. He was getting ready to do a tour starting tomorrow, and so he was in a very good mood, very frank.
He was in fantastic mood last night. I talked to him last night when we discussed some songs we were going to do on the tour and everything. He's in
there
a great mood.
Ill health?
None whatsoever.
How do you gentlemen feel about this?
I can't believe it. I just...
I could,
it's not real.
No, it's not. It's our friend.
Elvis is dead, but this program won't be his obituary. Rather, this is a tribute to the man who brought passion and sensitivity to the world of rock and roll music. We begin with a look at his beginnings. Said one newspaper woman in an early article, "I don't know what it is he's got, but he's got it. He moves, he struts, he shakes, he's mean, he's sweet, he's sex, but whatever." By the end of the year, his first year, Elvis was a giant hit, the owner of six Cadillacs. From there, he went on from his famous early television appearances to superstar status. It was only briefly interrupted by a stint in the army and a temporary retirement. He got his hair cut. He was in Germany. But his reputation and his fame survived, and his career wasn't interrupted. While he was in Germany, Elvis met a girl, the daughter of an Air Force officer. Her name, Priscilla. He was in love. Love Me Tender, in 1956, is perhaps his best-known movie, and the title song was certainly one of his best-known and biggest sellers. It was an anthem of the 50s, and still more romantic times. And there are other movies. Double Trouble, one of his attempts at serious movie-making, unsuccessful, almost a parody, but he did it. He carried it off. This is King Creole. One of the many movies Elvis made. Actually, he made 30 movies in all that grossed tens of millions of dollars. And of course, his records. Records that dated back from the early Sun Record days until the days when he signed with RCA Records. There's his marriage to Priscilla, a marriage that broke the heart of many a single girl in this country and abroad. Elvis Presley's fan club, back in the days when fan clubs were counted and courted, was at its peak some 400,000 certified members worldwide. But there's a very small fan club among entertainers, and that's a fan club that means a lot to other entertainers. And tonight there were tributes pouring in from all over the world from those entertainers. We have just a few of them for you.
He is a figure that really is part of our musical history, the things that he did during his career, the things that he created are really something important. He's going to leave millions and millions of friends and fans deeply bereaved, I'm sure, because he had an immense following. You could compare him to pretty near anyone, Sinatra, Elton John, or is he an Englishman? Neil Diamond, Sadaka, but in his time, in his day, Elvis was just as important as any of them, if not more so than most.
Among musicians, what do you think Presley will be remembered for most?
And shaky legs and fabulous teen music. Not too slight country western at all, because that's the way he started out. And his movies and the 50s.
Good Morning America's Rona Barrett remembers Elvis Presley in an interview this evening in Los Angeles.
I will never forget his return to Las Vegas at the Hilton. It was a night that will live with me forever. He was the personification of the word star. However, there existed a dichotomy in his personality, because while he was extremely religious on one hand, he could be frivolous on the other, and so insecure that he would walk on stage with a derringer in his boots. And in the end, still lonely, still insecure about a career that was constantly changing and still missing the warmth that only his mother could provide, Elvis Presley died an enigma, hopefully in peace. All his fans, including myself, will miss him.
As we all will. Las Vegas, as you know, was something of a second home for Elvis Presley, and while he was there, he had frequent checkups by a Las Vegas physician, Dr. Elias Gainan. Correspondent Gail Westrup of our Las Vegas affiliate, it's KSHO, talked to Dr. Gainan earlier today.
Drugs excessively lately?
Absolutely not. Elvis was never a drug taker, and he never took drugs at all. The only thing he took was sleeping pills just to sleep, just like everybody else, I guess, in his field. But I've never known Elvis to take any hard drugs whatsoever.
Do you suspect that his death may have been a drug overdose?
It could be. You know, I talked to his father in Memphis as soon as I heard the news. It was just a few minutes after he died, and he told me that it was a heart attack.
The king is dead. Long live the music. Long live the memory. Elvis Presley, we'll miss you. Good night. Thank you.